Hello dear student, welcome to the third lecture on game theory. In this lecture, we will study how to use graphical method to solve 2 cross n and m cross 2 games. So this is the given problem. Okay, we have to solve this game using graphical method. Now it is a 2 cross n game. Before we see how to use the graphical method to solve the 2 cross n game, okay, we will know little bit about the probabilities. Now this is the given game, okay, and the optimal strategy for the player A is found to be 0, 2 by 3 and 1 by 3, and for player B it is 0, 2 by 3 and 1 by 3. Now if you find out the sum of the probabilities of each of the player, it is found to be 1. That is, for the sum of the probabilities for player A is 0 plus 2 by 3 plus 1 by 3 is equal to 1, and sum of the probabilities for player B is 0 plus 2 by 3 plus 1 by 3, it is equal to 1. Let us consider one more example. Okay, so this is the game that is given, and the optimal strategy is for player A is 2 by 5, 3 by 5, 0 and 0, and for player B it is 1 by 2, 1 by 2 and 0. So now the sum of the probabilities for the player A will be 2 by 5 plus 3 by 5 plus 0 plus 0, that is equal to 1, and sum of the probabilities for player B is 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 0 is equal to 1. So the conclusion here is, if you consider any game, okay, the sum of the probabilities for any player is equal to 1. Now we got to know that the sum of the probabilities for each player in a game is 1. Okay, so let us assign the probability x and 1 minus x for player A. So adding up, we get x plus 1 minus x is equal to 1. Next, let us see how to use graphical method to solve 2 cross n game. Now this is the given problem. So it has 2 rows and 3 columns. It is a 2 cross n game, and with the understanding of the probability, okay, we will assign x and 1 minus x as a probability for the player A. That is, the probability that the player A chooses the strategy A1 is x, and the probability that player A chooses the strategy A2 is 1 minus x. Next, let us see what all the things we need to have to solve the problem using graphical method: this particular table and the graph. Now let us look into this table first. Okay, so the first column, in the first column we are going to write about the B strategy, the player B strategy, and in the next column we will be calculating what would be A's payoff for the corresponding strategy chosen by the player B. Okay, and then we will assign x is equal to 0 in the equation and x is equal to 1 in the equation. Now about this is how the graph will look like in solving these problems using graphical method. We'll discuss more about these graphs in the later slides. First, we shall see how to fill the table. So this is the given problem. It is a 2 cross n game. Okay, that is, there are 2 rows and 3 columns, and we will assign x and 1 minus x as a probability for the player A. Okay, so now we shall see to compute the values for the table. Okay, so B strategies we will be writing down first. Okay, that is, there are 3 strategies that is used by the player B, that is B1, B2, B3, write it here. Okay, next we have to calculate the A's payoff. That is, what would be the A's payoff for the corresponding strategies that is chosen by the player B. Now, if the player B chooses the strategy B1 to play the game, then what will be the A's pay off for it. Okay, let us see how to calculate this one. Okay, so that is, the player B uses the strategy B1 to play the game, then A's payoff for that will be minus 3 into x plus 2 into 1 minus x. Okay, so that is minus 3x plus 2 into 1 minus x, which is equal to minus 5x plus 2. Next, okay, we'll see how to compute the A's payoff for the strategy that is chosen by B, that is B2. Okay, so that is, if the player B chooses the strategy B2, then the A's payoff for that will be 4 into x plus minus 2 into 1 minus x. It will become plus 4x plus minus 2 into 1 minus x, which will become 6x minus 2. Next, the A's payoff for the strategy B3 is 2 into x plus minus 1 into 1 minus x, which will become 3x minus 1. Next, we will put x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 1 in these three equations. Now, putting x is equal to 0 in this first equation, we will get plus 2. Next, 6x minus 2, x is 0, so it is minus 2. Next, 3x minus 1, put x is equal to 0, we get the value minus 1. Next, we shall put x is equal to 1 in these three equations. Okay, putting x is equal to 1 in the first equation, we get minus 3. Putting x is equal to 1 in the second equation, that is 6x minus 2, we get 4. Okay, next, 3x minus 1, okay, putting x is equal to 1, we get 2. So, we have calculated the table. Next, let us know about the graph that is used here. Now, there are two vertical lines we are drawing here in the graph, okay, and this line represent the probability line, okay, and the when I say x is equal to 0, okay, it is not this particular point x is equal to 0. It is x is equal to 0. It is an equation, and that equation is represented by this whole line, the whole first line. Okay, similarly, when I say x is equal to 1, okay, it is this second line which represent that. Okay. Let me repeat it again. X is equal to 0 is the equation which represent the first line, and x is equal to 1 is the equation which represent this second line, okay, and this particular line, okay, is the probability line. Now, before we plot the points in a graph, let us know about the rules to solve the problem using graphical method. Now, the first rule says, okay, the first rule is for 2 cross n game, okay, so after we plot the graph, okay, we need to select the lower area of the graph covered by two or more straight lines and pick the highest point of that area, okay, that point we call it as maximin. Maximin means it is the maximum point out of the minimum. Okay, the second rule, okay, it is for m cross 2 games, and as I already told you, graphical method we are using to solve either 2 cross n game or m cross 2 game. Okay, so in this particular case, okay, we need to select the upper area of the graph supported by two or more straight lines, and we need to pick the lowest point of that area, okay, and that point we call it as minimax. Okay, that is, we are choosing a minimum point out of all the maximum points. Okay, so now we have calculated this payoff matrix and we have constructed the table, and let us see how to plot these points, okay, in the graph. there are two lines here, okay? The first line represent x is equal to 0 and the second line represent x is equal to 1, and this is the probability line, and above the probability line all the values are positive and below the probability line all the values are negative. Now let us consider the first point, that is with respect to B1 strategy, okay, that is the values are 2 and minus 3, okay. So we shall plot this point 2 on x is equal to 0 and minus 3 on x is equal to 1. On doing this we get, okay, that is this is plus 2 and this is minus 3, okay. Draw line, okay, which connects those two points and name it as B1, the strategy B1. Next let us see, okay, how to plot the second strategy point, that is minus 2 and 4. Okay, so minus 2, okay, we have to plot it on x is equal to 0 line, and 4 we have to plot it on x is equal to 1. Okay, so it is minus 2 and plus 4, okay, join this. Next we have to plot the third point, that is minus 1 and 2, okay. Minus 1 on x is equal to 0 and plus 2 on x is equal to 1, okay, join those two points, okay, and name it as B3. So this is a graph that we got. Now the next thing is, we need to, for a 2 cross n games, we need to select the lower area of the graph, okay. And whenever you are selecting the lower area of the graph, okay, please do not consider this probability line, okay. So now without the probability line, the lower area of the graph look like this. Now once you mark the lower area of the graph, the next thing is you need to select the maximum point out of the minimum, that is you need to find out the maximin. So this is the maximin point, okay. So it's more clear here. So you have to leave this probability line, okay, and you need to consider the lower area, and in the lower area the maximum point you need to choose. Now you can notice that this maximum point, okay, that is this maximin, is lies at the intersection of the line B3 and B1. So we are going to take up only these two strategies, okay, to solve the game hereafter, okay. So now this was the given problem, okay, and using a graphical method we have reduced the 2 cross 3 game, okay, the given 2 cross 3 game to 2 cross 2 game now, okay. So here you, that we got using this maximin point, okay. This maximin point is obtained using the line B1 and B2, so we are going to keep only this B1 and B3, okay. So we are going to keep only this B1 and B3 strategies, and we are letting off this B2 from the table. So this is the given payoff matrix. Now it is reduced to 2 cross 2 matrix using the graphical method. So the main aim of the graphical method in case of 2 cross n games is to reduce the number of columns to 2. So 2 cross n games, okay, will be reduced to 2 cross 2 games using graphical method. Okay, now we have the payoff matrix which is 2 cross 2. We can apply the arithmetic method to solve this game. First we shall compute the oddments. The oddments for the first row is calculated using the second row values, that is 2 minus of minus 1 is equal to 3, and for the second row the oddment is calculated using the first row values, that is minus 3 minus 2, which is equal to 5. So here we are considering the absolute values, okay, so it is 3 and 5. Okay, now similarly the oddments for the first column is calculated using the second column value, that is 2 minus of minus 1 is equal to 3, and for the second column the oddment is calculated using the first column value, that is minus 3 minus 2, which is minus 5. Absolute value of minus 5 is 5. Next we shall compute the probability. Okay, the probability for the first row is 3 divided by 3 plus 5, that is equal to 3 by 8. The second row is 5 divided by 3 plus 5, which is equal to 5 by 8. And the first column probability is 3 divided by 3 plus 5, which is equal to 3 by 8. And the second column value is 5 divided by 3 plus 5, that is equal to 5 by 8. Next we shall compute the value of game. The value of game is minus 3 into minus 1 minus 2 into 2 whole divided by minus 3 minus 1 minus 2 plus 2, which is equal to 1 by 8. And the optimal strategy we will write down here. Okay, for A it is this one, 3 by 8 and 5 by 8. The optimal strategy for player B is B1 is 3 by 8, B2 is 0 because that particular strategy is eliminated, and B3 is 5 by 8. So that thing we have written here. Okay, so A's optimal strategy for player A is 3 by 8 and 5 by 8, and for player B it is 3 by 8, 0 and 5 by 8. 0 because the second strategy, that is B2 strategy of player B, is eliminated. Let us consider the second example. So here the payoff matrix is for player A is given. It is 2 cross 4 game, which is of type 2 cross n. So now we can use graphical method to solve this game. Firstly, we will calculate the values to plot the graph. So the first column, in the first column we will be listing out the strategies used by the player B, and in the second column we are going to calculate what would be the A's payoff with respect to the strategy chosen by the player B, and then we will put x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 1 in the equations. So there are four strategies that is used by the player B, that is B1, B2, B3 and B4, and the A's payoff with respect to these strategies is calculated as follows. Okay, so the player A, suppose if the player B chooses the strategy B1, then A's payoff would be 2 into x plus 4 into 1 minus x, which is equal to 4 minus 2x. Suppose if the player B chooses this strategy B2, then player A's payoff would be 2 into x plus 3 into 1 minus x, which is equal to 3 minus x. Now suppose if the player B chooses the strategy B3, then the A's payoff would be 3 into x plus 2 into 1 minus x, which is equal to x plus 2. If the player B chooses the strategy B4, then A's payoff for it will be minus 2 into x
plus 6 into 1 minus x, which is equal to 6 minus 8x. Now we'll put x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 1 here. Now putting x is equal to 0 in this first equation, that is 4 minus 2x, we'll get 4, and next 3 minus x will become 3 minus 0, that is 3. X plus 2 is 0 plus 2, it is 2. 6 minus 8 into 0, which is equal to 6. Next we shall put x is equal to 1 in these four equation. Putting x is equal to 1 in the first equation, 4 minus 2x we get 2, 3 minus x we get 2, 1 plus 2 which is equal to 3, 6 minus 8 into 1 we get minus 2. Now these points we will plot in a graph. So these are the points, okay, so the graph is plotted here. So consider the first set of points, that is 4 and 2. Okay, so we shall mark 4 in the line x is equal to 0 and 2 in the line x is equal to 1. So it is 4 and 2. So draw a line over this. Next, consider the second set of point, that is 3 and 2. Mark 3 on the line x is equal to 0 and mark 2 on the line x is equal to 1, that is this one, 3 and 2. Okay, so draw a line which connects these two points and name it as B2. Next set of point is 2 and 3. So on the line x is equal to 0 we will mark 2, and on the line x is equal to 1 we will mark 3, and join these two points and name it as B3, line B3. Next set of point is 6 and minus 2. 6 we shall point on x is equal to 0, minus 2 we shall point on x is equal to 1. Draw line and name it as B4. Next we need to shade or identify the lower region of the graph. So this is the lower region of the graph. Okay, so this is the lower region of the graph, and next we need to pick the maximum point out of the minimum points here. The minimum points are, one is this one and one more is this one. Okay, and one more is this one. And now out of these three points, the maximum point is 22. Maximum point is this one. And this maximum point lies at the intersection of the line B4 and B3. That is, we are going to keep only the strategies B4 and B3, and B1 and B2 is reduced. So this value 22/9 is nothing but the value of a game point. Okay, so this was the given problem with the four strategies used by the player B. Now it is being reduced to 2x2 game, okay, with the two strategies of the player B, that is B3 and B4. That is, we got the maximum point at the intersection of the line B3 and B4. So we will keep B3 and B4 and eliminate the remaining B1 and B2 columns. So write down the payoff matrix, that is, with respect to B3, the payoff is 3 and 2. With respect to B4, the payoff is minus 2 and 6. Next, we will solve this 2x2 game using arithmetic method. So firstly we will calculate the oddments. Oddments for the first row is calculated using the second row values, that is absolute value we will be taking. So 2 minus 6 which will be 4, and 3 minus of minus 2 which is equal to 5. And for oddments for the first column is minus 2 minus 6 which is equal to minus 8, absolute value is 8. And for the second column the value is 3 minus 2 which is equal to 1. Next we will calculate the probability. Probability for the first row is oddment value, that is 4, divided by the sum of the oddment, that is 4 by 9. Next 5 divided by 9, 5 by 9. Next probability for the first column is, it is 8 divided by 8 plus 1 which is equal to 9, 8 by 9. The probability for the second column is 1 divided by 8 plus 1, 9. So it is 1 by 9. The value of game is 3 into 6 minus minus 2 into 2 whole divided by 3 plus 6 minus minus 2 plus 2 which is equal to 22 by 9. So which comes across to 2.44. So this value of game is nothing but the maximum point. So you can see here 2.44 is the value of the maximum which lies at the intersection of the line B3 and B4. Next, let us write down the optimal strategy. The optimal strategy for player A is, it is 4 by 9 and 5 by 9. And for player B is, B1 is 0, B2 is 0, and B3 is 8 by 9, B4 is 1 by 9. So this is the optimal strategies used by the player A and B. Till now we have seen how to solve 2 cross n game using graphical method. Now let us see how we can solve m cross 2 games using graphical method. So this is the payoff matrix that is given, that is player A uses 3 strategies to play the game and player B uses 2 strategies to play the game. So there are 3 rows and 2 columns, so it is 3 cross 2 games. In general it is m cross 2 game. Now let us see how the table is going to change in case of m cross 2 game. So before, previously for 2 cross n game we used to write the A strategy in the first column. Next we will be calculating what is A's payoff and then put x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1. Now here we will be assigning a probability y and 1 minus y for the player B, so that y plus 1 minus y is equal to 1. That is that is if you consider the probability of each player in a game, its sum will be equal to 1. So y plus 1 minus y is equal to 1. So here in case of 2 cross n game we were assigning probability for the player A as x and 1 minus x. Here we will be assigning a probability y and 1 minus y for the player B with respect to the strategy B1 and B2 respectively. Now here in the table, we will be listing out all the A strategy and we will be calculating what would be the B's payoff with respect to the strategy chosen by the player A, and then we will put y is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1. Now the graph remains the same except that the first vertical line is for the equation y is equal to 0 and the second vertical line is for the equation y is equal to 1. Now let us see how to compute the values for the table. So this is the given payoff matrix. We will assign y as a probability to the strategy B1 and then 1 minus y to B2. So this is how we calculate the table. We will be listing out the strategies of A here, that is A1, A2, A3. There are three strategies taken by the player A to play the game. Okay, and next we will be calculating what would be the B's payoff. Now, if the player A, okay, if the player A chooses the strategy A1 to play the game, then B's payoff for it will be 5 into y plus 3 into 1 minus y. Okay, that is 5y plus 3 into 1 minus y will give you 2y plus 3. Similarly, if the player A chooses the strategy A2 to play the game, then B's payoff for that would be 2 into 1 into y plus 4 into 1 minus y. Okay, that is 2y plus 4 into 1 minus y will give you minus 2y plus 4. Similarly, if the player A chooses a strategy A3 to play the game, then B's payoff would be 1 into y plus 6 into 1 minus y, which will give you 5 minus 5y plus 6. Let me repeat it again. If the player A chooses the strategy A1, then player B's payoff would be 5 into y plus 3 into 1 minus y. Okay, so, and one more thing, in one more way you can remember this table is, see here it is a 3 cross 2 game. Okay, so now we would like to reduce this game to 2 cross 2 game so that we can apply the arithmetic method to solve the game. Okay, so now we would like to reduce the number of rows here, that is 3 rows to 2 rows. So that thing we will be writing here. Okay, so which one we have to reduce, that thing we will be writing under the first column. Okay, so the next is, okay, we will assign y is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1 in these three equations. Assigning y is equal to 0 in the first equation, that is 2y plus 3, we get 2 into 0 plus 3, which is 3. Next, minus 2y plus 4, assigning 0 here, we get 4. And next, minus 5 into 0 plus 6, we get 6. Next, we shall assign y is equal to 1 in these three equations. Okay, we'll assign y is equal to 1 to the first equation, 2y plus 3, which will becomes 2 into 1 plus 3, which is 5, minus 2 into 1 plus 4 becomes 3, minus 5 into 1 plus 6 becomes 1. Next, we shall see how to plot these points in a graph. So this is the payoff matrix. This is the values that we got. So we will be drawing three lines because there are three strategies. So we shall plot the first set of points, that is 3 and 5. Okay, so we have to plot 3 on y is equal to 0 line. So here y is equal to, that is 3, okay, on 3 we have to plot on y is equal to 0 line, and the next point 5 we have to draw on y is equal to 1. So this is that point, so join them, okay, using a straight line. Okay, so the first black this black color line shows the first set of point and name it as A1. Next, we shall plot the next set of points, that is 4 and 3. Okay, so 4 should be on y is equal to 0 line and 3 should be on y is equal to 1 line. So this is 4 and then 3 will come here. Okay, so join them using the straight line and name it as A2. So the blue color line that is drawn here represent the second set of points, that is 4 and 3. Next, plot 6 and 1, the third set of point in a graph. Okay, 6 has to be on y is equal to 0 line and 1 has to be on y is equal to 1 line. So okay, so 6 comes here and y is and 1 on line y is equal to 1. This is that point. Okay, join them using the straight line. So the red color line that is drawn here represent the third set of point with respect to the strategy A3. Okay, after you draw each line, please name them, okay, as A1, A2, A3 here. Now, once you draw the graph, the rule says for M cross 2 game is, okay, we need to select the upper area of the graph supported by two or more straight lines and you need to pick the lowest point of that area. That is, we need to choose the minimax point. That is, we need to select minimum point out of all the maximum point. Now, if you consider this graph, okay, so the upper area of the graph is this one, okay, the shaded region, okay, and there are three points here, okay, this is the first point, this is the second point, and this is the third point in the upper area of a graph, and we need to choose the minimum out of all the maximum point, okay, so the minimum out of this first one, second one, and the third one is this particular point. Now, you can see that this particular point, we say it is a minimax, that is minimum point out of all the maximum point, okay, it lies at the intersection of the line A1 and A3, okay, so just circle them, okay, just circle them, those two lines, that is A1 and A3, okay, will give you the minimax point, okay, so the minimax will lie at the intersection of the line A1 and A3. Okay, let me repeat it again. Okay, you need to choose the upper area of the graph, okay, and then you need to select the minimum point out of all the maximum point, okay, and the upper area of the graph can be formed by two or more lines. So after finding the minimax point and knowing the fact that it is obtained by the intersection of A1 and line A3, okay, now we would reduce this matrix, okay, we would reduce this given matrix to this. The given 3 cross 2 game now become 2 cross 2 game, okay, so that is, we will be keeping only the strategy A1 and A3, okay, that is what the intention of using the graphical method, okay, so now in case of M cross 2 games, after we apply the graphical method, okay, we will reduce the number of rows to 2. Next, this is a 2 cross 2 game. Now we can solve it using arithmetic method. Okay, first we'll calculate the oddments. Okay, see the oddments for the first row. The oddments for the first row is calculated using the second row value, okay, that is absolute value of the difference between 1 minus 6, 1 and 6 is 5, okay, and the difference between, absolute difference between 5 and 3 is 2, and the oddment for the first column, okay, is obtained by using the difference between the two elements of the second column, okay, the absolute difference between 3 and 6 is 3, okay, and the oddments for the second column is 5 minus 1, which is nothing but 4. Next, we shall calculate the probability, okay, probability is 5 divided by 5 plus 2, which is equal to 5 by 7, okay, and the oddments for the second row is, okay, the probability for the second row is 2 divided by 5 plus 2, which is 7, okay, similarly the probability for the first column is 3 divided by 3 plus 4 which is 7, so it becomes 3 by 7. Next 4 divided by 3 plus 4, that is 4 by 7. Next we shall calculate the value of a game. The value of a game is calculated like this, okay, that is 5 into 6 minus 3 into 1, 3 into 1 whole divided by 6 plus 5 minus 3 plus 1, which will give you 27 by 7, which is equal to 3.85. actually this value of game is the minimax value will be this value of game, that is 3.85. so if you look at the graph, this point is nothing but 3.85. So the optimal strategy, okay, of the game is for player A it is 5 by 7 and 2 by 7, wherein the strategy A2 is eliminated, so its value is 0 here. So the optimal strategy for player A is 5 by 7, 0 and 2 by 7, and for player B it is 3 by 7 and 4 by 7. So this is the solution to the given M x 2 game using graphical method. Now let us see how to we'll consider one more example, okay. And the question given is we have to solve the game using the graphical method. Now if you observe this payoff matrix, okay, it is of type M x 2, okay. So we can solve M x 2 game using graphical method. So let us compute the table for this, okay. So in case of M x 2 game, the first column is with respect to writing the A strategy. Next we will be calculating what is B's payoff. Next we will assign y is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1, okay, which is nothing but the two vertical lines that is used in the graph, okay. So now here you can see that in the following game, okay, there are four strategy used by the player A. So list out those four strategies: A1, A2, A3, A4. Next calculate the corresponding B's payoff with respect to the strategy chosen by A, that is A1, A2, A3 and A4. Now if the player A, okay, so if the player A chooses the strategy A1, then B's payoff for that would be, it is minus 2 into y plus 0 into 1 minus y, which will give you minus 2y. And if the player A chooses the strategy A2, then B's payoff for that would be 3 into y plus minus 1 into 1 minus y, which is equal to 4y minus 1. And if the player A chooses the strategy A3, then B's payoff for that would be minus 3 into y plus 2 into 1 minus y, which is nothing but 5y plus 2. Next, if the player A chooses the strategy A4, then B's payoff would be 5 into y plus minus 4 into 1 minus y, which is equal to 9y minus 4. Okay, next we will put y is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1 in these four equations. Okay, putting y is equal to 0 in the first equation, we get 0, and putting y is equal to 0 in the second equation, okay, we get minus 1, and putting y is equal to 0 in the third equation, we get 2, and putting y is equal to 0 in the fourth equation, 9 into 0 minus 4, which will give you minus 4. Next, assign y is equal to 1, okay, in the first equation, so it becomes minus 2 into 1, which is minus 2, and 4 into 1 minus 1, which gives you 3, 5 into 1 plus 2, which will give you minus 3, 9 into 1 minus 4, which will give you plus 5. Next, we shall plot this point on a graph. So the first vertical line is for y is equal to 0. Next vertical line is for y is equal to 1. So this is the probability line we are drawing. Above the probability line, all the points are positive. Below the probability line, all the points are negative. Okay, so we shall take the first set of points, that is 0 and minus 2, and we shall plot on a graph. 0 has to be plotted on a line y is equal to 0. Minus 2 has to be plotted on a line y is equal to 1. So this is that line. After drawing the line, okay, so mark the line as the strategy A1. Next, the set of point is minus 1 and 3. Okay, plot minus 1, okay, on y is equal to 0 and 3 on y is equal to 1. Okay, so join them and name it as A2. Next, we need to consider this next set of point, that is 2 and minus 3. So 2 on y is equal to 0 and minus 3 on y is equal to 1, join them. So this is the third line, okay, so name it as A3. Next is the set of points minus 4 and 5. Okay, so minus 4 on y is equal to 0 and 5 on y is equal to 1. So join them and name it as A4. The next thing is we need to consider, or we need to shade the upper part of the graph. So this is the upper part of the graph. Okay, so the shaded line here, this is the upper part of the graph. Now there are 4 points here. Okay, so this is the first point, this is the second point, this is the third point, and this is a 4th point in the upper area of the graph. Now out of all this maximum point, we need to consider the minimum. Okay, and the minimum will be this one. Okay, so this is the minimax point. Okay, so next thing is you need to identify which two lines at which two lines the minimax point is intersecting. So the minimax point lies at the intersection of the line A3 and A2. Okay, please do circle it like this so that you can identify which strategy you will be keeping in the payoff matrix. Okay, so minimax, okay, so this is that minimax point which lies at the intersection of the line A2 and A3. So in the payoff matrix, we will be keeping only the strategy A2 and A3 with respect to player A and eliminate A4 and A1. Okay, so this is the reduced payoff matrix now. Okay, so with respect to player A, we will be keeping A2 and A3, and for player B strategies B1 and B2, and write down the payoff matrix. Okay, next thing is, this is a 2x2 game. We can solve it using arithmetic method. We need to calculate the oddments value and the probability. Oddments for the first row is 5. Oddment for the second row is 4. Oddment for the first column is 3. Oddment for the second column is 6. Probability, it is 5 divided by 5 plus 4 is 9, so it is 5 by 9. Next, it is 4 divided by 9. Next, probability for B1 is 3 by 9. Probability for B2 is 6 by 9. Now see, if you sum off these probabilities, that is 3 by 9 plus 6 by 9, it will give you 1. Similarly, 5 by 9 plus 4 by 9 adding up will give you 1. So that means the sum of the probabilities of each player in a game is equal to 1. Next, we'll calculate the value of game. Okay, value of game is 3 into 2 minus 1 into minus 3 whole divided by 3 plus 2 minus 1 minus 3, which will give you 3 by 9. So it is 1 by 3. And the optimal strategy is, for player A, we have eliminated the strategy A1 and A4. So A1 and A4 value is 0, and A2 and A3 probability is 5 by 9 and 4 by 9. So the optimal strategy for player A is, okay, 0, 5 by 9, 4 by 9 and 0. And for player B, it is the probability 3 by 9 and 6 by 9. So 3 by 9 and 6 by 9. and this 1 by 3 value of a game is nothing but the minimax point. Okay, so please do solve this homework problem in your notebook. Okay, so now the first problem, homework problem, is this one. Now the question given is solve by graphical method. Now if you consider this payoff matrix, it is of type 4 cross 4 game. Okay, so we cannot use graphical method to solve this m cross n game. Okay, it has to be either m cross 2 or 2 cross n game. Now what we can do is, okay, this m cross n game, that is 4 cross 4 game, okay, we have to reduce it to either 2 cross n or m cross 2 game using dominance rule method, and then you can apply the graphical method. Okay, so this is the hint that is given. Okay, so if the given problem is of m cross n game and it is asked that solve it by using the graphical method, then you have to reduce this matrix to either 2 cross n game or m cross 2 game using the dominance rule method. Okay, and then you can use the graphical method to solve the problem. I hope you know how to solve the dominance rule method. This is the next homework problem. Okay, so this is of type 2 cross m game, so no problem with this, you can solve this using graphical method. So this is the third problem. Okay, so it is 2 cross 5 game, which is nothing in general 2 cross n game. Solve it using graphical method.